to Logical Ayurveda. Today we are going to see about the disease called Parikartika. Pari means all around and Kartanam denotes the act of cutting. So the word meaning of Parikartika denotes a tear or cut anywhere in the anal mucosa. In contemporary science, it can almost be equated to fissure in ano. Fissure in ano is a cut or tear that is caused in anal mucosa because of a constipated or dry stool, a dry bowel which itself becomes like a knife. During the process of defecation, that cuts through the anal canal because of its very hard nature. That is fissure in ano. Before I go into this video of Parikartika, I'll tell you why Parikartika is very much important to an Ayurveda practitioner. Parikartika, the anorectal problems constitute of 40% of the cases that come to the Ayurveda OPD. Symptoms of fissure in ano are cutting type of pain in the anal region during defecation, spasm during defecation, burning sensation, bleeding before and after defecation. This is one of the important points that you can differentiate fissure in ano from other anorectal problems, because bleeding just before the bowel movement and after the bowel movement is a typical symptom of fissure in ano. And hard and constipated bowels, which patients feel very difficult to evacuate. Most of the patients of fissure in ano, even if they have a bowel movement, they tend to suppress it because of the pain involved while defecation, which causes further more problems, which worsens the problem. So after hearing all these symptoms, before moving on to the treatment, it is very important that you should examine the patient physically. The problem with most of the anorectal patients is, according to them, each and every anorectal problem is called piles. Even internal piles is piles, external piles is piles, fissure in ano is piles, fistula is piles, abscess is piles, everything is piles according to the patient. And we are also very surprised that, because of the comfort, every doctor say to the patient it is piles, because it is very difficult to make them understand about fissure in ano or fistula. Every doctor tend to tell them that it is piles, I am giving treatment for piles. So before giving such a statement, it is very important that you examine the patient, because fissure in ano can be primary or secondary. So on the physical examination of patient during Darshana Pariksha, you can either see a cut or tear in the anal mucosa, which is a fresh fissure which has recently happened, or if you see the sentinel tag, the pile mass, the finger-like projection, small fingerless finger projections, that is called sentinel tag. It denotes that it is a chronic fissure, at least it is 6 months old. Proctoscopy is not advised in fissure in ano patients with the severe pain, because during the episode of severe pain, there will be always spasm, and inserting a proctoscope will do much more harm than good. If possible, you can do a digital examination. And most of the time, the cut or tear in the anal mucosa will be in 12 o'clock positions. 90% of the time or 80% of the time, the tear in anal mucosa, in practice, we see it at 12 o'clock or 6 o'clock. The other positions like 3 o'clock or 9 o'clock are very rare, but it also comes. So, moving into samprapti of fissure in ano. As I told earlier, the common samprapti is that the bowel becomes very hard. The bowel itself becomes like a knife that cuts through the anal mucosa, causes bleeding, burning sensation and pain, etc. So, let's see how Vata, Pitta and Kapha single-handedly produces the fissure in ano, and there is a difference in samprapti, and how could we better treat them. In Vata, there will be excruciating pain, Ati Tivra Ruja, and spasms will be more. The anal canal will be shrunk very much. Shrinkage of the anal sphincter, because Vata has the capability of shrinking the shrotas. So the anal canal will be very, very much tight in Vata cases, and there will be extreme pain and spasm during the bowel movement, and there will also be gas and Vishtabdha Ajirna associated. Okay. And in Pitta, there will be much more burning sensation than pain. Burning sensation, the patient will feel much more burning than pain, and the bleeding will be profuse. The bleeding will be more in Pitta kind of fissures. Kapha kind of fissures are very rare,
it occurs as the complication of the grahani or the irritable bowel syndrome or ulcerative colitis in such cases. The kapha symptoms constitute only 5 to 10% of the cases, but still the symptoms of kapha, their mild pain will be there and itching in the anal mucosa because of the improper defecation of the bowel, and bloated abdomen are the symptoms of kaphaja types of fissure. So let us see each dosha in detail. So before differentiating the disease into vata, pitta, kapha, and we have to remember this, pitta is a main dosha and pitta is basic dosha in the fissure. So there will be always basically pitta involved with the differentiation of vata, pitta and kapha. So in vataja fissure in ano, you have nidanas like smoking, an intake of excessive ruksha foods which contains very less water like chapati or jola roti. So people who tend to travel very much, people whose sphincter is having spasm because of traveling, and excessive dehydration, people who are dehydrated much, their bowel becomes very hard, and people who fast excessively. We can commonly see in the clinic that because of fasting, lot of patients come because of fissure in ano. So all these ruksha nidanas cause shoshan of jala in the purushavaha shrotas, and the motion becomes very hard. Therefore, it becomes like a knife which cuts through the anal canal, and all the common fissure in ano symptoms happen. So main differentiating factor is excruciating pain. In vata, the pain will be much more than burning sensation. When coming to the pitta, the nidanas will be mostly ushna and ruksha in nature. Intake of excessive amla and kattu aharas, excessive amla like lemon rice and tomato rice, etc. The people who do madhyapana, people who take alcohol excessively, and people who take ushnaharas like chicken and aharas which are very spicy in nature. So the pitta is always associated with, or most of the time it is associated with gastritis, that is vidagdha ajirna, burning sensation during abdomen. So because of all these foodstuffs, because of the ushna and ruksha, it again causes jalashoshana in the purushavaha shrotas, and the main symptom will be burning sensation because of the ushna nidana involved, and bleeding excessively because of the ushna guna nature of the pitta. When it comes to kapha, the kaphaja cases are very rare. What happens in kapha is basically because of agni mandya, because of the ama jirna, because of manda guna vriddhi. For example, people who take oily food more, people who take food like maida excessively, which can constipate and which can give pressure on the agni, which reduces the agni. Because of the agni mandya, the improper food which is not digested will not have a proper evacuation. Thereby the motion becomes hard, and thereby they have fissure. It is secondary, it is always they will having secondary disease like grahani, where there will be particular episodes of constipation and then particular episodes of diarrhea. During the time of constipation, when they try to excessively put pressure for bowel evacuation, then fissure happens. These type of cases are rare, but then you should also know about this samprapti of kaphaja nidanas. In kapha, because of the there will be associated gulma, so there will be only mild pain. In kapha, there will always be mild pain and lot of itching because of the improper bowel evacuation. Kapha patient will never have the satisfaction of complete bowel evacuation, and there will be bloated abdomen. So all these symptoms will make you understand that this is a kaphaja patient. So this video is all about the diagnosis and understanding of the samprapti of fissure in ano. The treatment of fissure in ano involves medical aspects to surgical aspects, and it is a little bit long and it is very complicated to explain. So to make it simpler, I am making a separate video on treatment of fissure in ano as a separate video. So look forward to seeing the part 2.